This, of course, gives various difficulties. Because here I've tried, just out of my own experience of 9 years now living in rural Zambia, before that 2 years in rural Zimbabwe, and some other areas in the world, what the differences are in the daily activities. And they're huge. They're almost mirrored. In a Western situation, it's the rational why we do things. In an African situation, it's the relational why you do things. These words hardly exist. If you Google them, you find very little. But you do things because the relationships are there, not because it makes rational sense. First about relationships. So it's first about who is around and then what. I guess you also work with your friends like that. Let's hang out together. You are there together. Oh, who's all there? What are we going to do? It comes after all the people are there. And it's not that we bring people together because of what we want to achieve. What is more important, people or things? An African will say people at all times. Actually, when things are there and when no people around, there's nothing. It's the issue of when a tree falls in the forest, does it make sounds if there is no one listening to it? It's about responsibilities, not about rights, and so on and so on. And one of the most important things that we can discuss a bit later is about it's about orality and not about literacy. Theory will show you, mainly Western theory, that, literacy is superseding orality. In my view, it exists side to side. And we see that in the West also. I think our youth right now is growing up in a second orality where you don't write really much. You make your videos and you talk to the computers and you make YouTubes and stuff. And who is going to read that? And even if I was observing how people were looking at their Facebook page today, people are not reading everything. They're just skipping. And it's a way of ours interacting. Why do we still need words, actually? That's a question. That's an honest question that we hardly ask ourselves. But it's a very important thing that we can learn from and from our African situation. It's also in a situation where we talk about a scarcity and an abundance. Of course, it's known that in Africa there's sometimes very little what is actually working. But with what we have there, we make it work. Well, here we can go to a shop. Well, our nearby shop is about 400 kilometers away, 1 hour flight, or 6 hours drive that you hope you will survive. So it's about authority, where it is vested in a chief, while here it's about power. I have the biggest gun. And so on and so on. There's a lot that we can discuss about this, but this is crucial stuff. The question is, what is in the middle? Why is this different? And I would say that how we can talk with each other is about our values. Ethics and values, that's how we bridge these the gaps. All right, so we talked about Africa, we talked about what internet, we talked about the culture and about the context. Is that now possible with all these difficulties? Because this is a different world, but it's not unique. There is a saying about the other 3 billion. You might have heard of that. That is, all these people live in these environments. I'm pretty sure that in Latin America or in Asia, you'll find communities like this. And actually, more than half of the world might be like this. It's research that needs to be done to validate what I'm just saying. But is that research being done? Of course, it's being done in anthropology. But we need engineers. We need economists. We need people from all different departments to work together to figure out these things.